76, this is because Allah has revealed the book in truth, and surely those who differ regarding it are totally engrossed in opposition. 177, righteousness is not in turning your faces towards the east or the west, rather the righteous are those who believe in Allah and the last day, the angel, the books and the prophets, who give charity out of their cherished wealth to relatives, orphans, the poor, needy, travelers, beggars and all feeding captives, who establish prayer, pay all tax and keep the pledges they make, and who are patient in times of suffering, adversity and in the heat of battle. It is they who are true in faith, and it is they who are mindful of Allah. 178, O believers, the law of retaliation is set for you in case of murder. A free man for a free man, a slave for a slave, a female for a female. But if the offender is pardoned by victim's guardian, then blood money should be decided fairly and payment should be made courteously. This is a concession and mercy from our Lord, but whoever transgresses after that will suffer a painful punishment. 179, there is security of life for you in law of retaliation. O people of reason, so that you may become mindful of Allah. 180, it is prescribed that when death approaches any of you, if they leave something of value, a will should be made in favor of parents, immediate family and with fairness. This is an obligation on those who are mindful of Allah. 181, but whoever changes the will after hearing it, the blame will only be on those who made the change. Indeed, Allah is all hearing, all knowing. 182, whoever suspects an error of an injustice, the will brings about a fair settlement among the parties will not be sinful. Surely Allah is all forgiving, most merciful. 183, O believers, fasting is prescribed for you as it was for those before you. So perhaps you will become mindful of Allah. 1st day, prescribed number of days, but whoever of you is ill or on a journey, then let them fast an equal number of days after Ramadan. And for those who can only fast with extreme difficulty, compensation can be made by feeding an needy person. For every day not fasted, but whoever volunteers give more, it is better for them. So to fast is better for you, if only you knew. 185, Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed as a guide for humanity, with clear proofs of guidance and the standard to distinguish between right and wrong. So whoever is present this month, let them fast. But whoever is ill or on a journey, let them fast an equal number of days after Ramadan. Allah intends ease for you, not hardship, so that you may complete the prescribed period and proclaim the greatness of Allah for guiding you, and perhaps you will be grateful. 186, when my servants ask you, O prophet, about me, I am truly near. I respond to one's prayer when they call upon me, so let them respond with obedience to me and believe in me, perhaps they will be guided to the right way. 187. It has been made permissible for you to be intimate with your wives during nights preceding the fast. Your spouses are a garment for you as you are for them, and Allah knows that you are deceiving yourselves. So He accepted your repentance and pardoned you. So now you may intimate with them and seek what Allah has prescribed for you. You may eat and drink until you see the light of dawn, breaking the darkness of light, then complete the fast until night falls. Do not intimate with your spouses while you are meditating in mosques. These are the limits set by Allah, so do not exceed them. This is how Allah makes His revelations clear to people, so they may become mindful of Him. 188. Do not consume one another's wealth unjustly, nor deliberately bribe authorities in order to defer a portion of others' property, knowing that it is a sin. They ask you, O prophet, about the phases of moon. Say, they are means for people to determine time and pilgrimage. Righteousness is not in entering your houses from back doors. Rather, righteousness is to be mindful of Allah. So enter your homes through proper doors and be mindful of Allah, so you may be successful. 190. Fight in the cause of Allah only against those who war against you, but do not exceed the limits. Allah does not like transgressors. 191. Kill them whenever you come upon them and drive them out of the places from which they have been driven you out. For persecution is far worse than killing. And do not fight them at the sacred mosque unless they attack you there. If they do so, then fight them. That is the reward of the disbelievers. 192. But if they cease, then surely Allah is all forgiving, most merciful. 193. Fight against them if they persecute you until there is no more persecution, and your devotion will be to Allah alone. If they stop persecuting you, let there be no hostility except against the aggressors. 194. There will be retaliation in a sacred month for an offense in sacred month, and all violations will bring about retaliation. So if anyone attacks you, retaliate in the same manner, but be mindful of Allah and know that Allah is with those mindful of Him. 195. Spend in the cause of Allah and do not let your own hands throw you into destruction by withholding, and do good, for Allah certainly loves the good doers. 196. Complete the pilgrimage and minor pilgrimage for Allah, but if prevented from proceeding, then offer whatever sacrificial animals you can afford, and do not shave your heads until sacrificial animal reaches its destination. But if any of you is ill or has a scalp ailment requiring shaving, then compensate either by fasting, charity, or a sacrificial offering. In the times of peace, you may combine the pilgrimage and minor pilgrimage, then make the sacrificial offering you can afford. Whoever cannot afford the offering, let them fast 3 days during pilgrimage and 7 after returning home. Completing 10. These offerings are for those who do not live near the sacred house and be mindful of Allah and know that Allah is severe in punishment. 197. Commitment to pilgrimage is made in appointed months. Whoever commits to performing pilgrimage, let them stay away from intimate relations, foul language, and arguments during pilgrimage. Whatever good you do, Allah fully knows it. Take necessary provisions for the journey. Surely the best provision is righteousness, and be mindful of me, O Prophet, O people of reason. 198. There is no blame on you for seeking the bounty of your Lord during this journey. When you return from Arafat, praise Allah near the sacred place and praise Him for having guided you, for surely before this guidance you were astray. For surely before this guidance you were astray. 199. Then go forth with rest of the pilgrims and seek Allah's forgiveness. Surely Allah is all forgiving, most merciful. 200. When you have fulfilled your sacred rites, praise Allah as you used to praise your forefathers before Islam, or even passionately. There are some who say, "Our Lord, grant us your bounties in this world," but they will have no share in the hereafter.